Detective
Truth Frequency Radio.
Can you count, suckers? I say the future is ours. If you can count. Now look, what we have here before.
Broadcasting straight to you from a large spaceship, currently anchored, yes, anchored, until further notice, above Raleigh, North Carolina, eagerly awaiting the 2017 Flat Earth Conference. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. I'm your host, Mark Sargent, the creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure thousands of miles wide. Check it out at marksargent.com and closedworld.com, or just Google Flat Earth Clues. If you can't find it, what are you doing? You're not very good at computers. For those of you listening to this on YouTube and you want to hear the show live as it happens, please go to Truth Frequency Radio for the latest schedule. Currently, this show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern. Tonight is February 14th, Valentine's Day, 2017. If you are not hearing this on Valentine's Day, then it is a recording, in which case you do not want to call the phone number because it's just going to go to voicemail. But that number will work, just so you know. Quote of the day from the Peanut Gallery: the scientific man does not aim at an immediate result. He does not expect that his advanced ideas will readily be taken up. His work is like that of a planter for the future. His duty is to lay the foundation for those who are to come and point the way. Who said that? Nikola Tesla. Who, by the way, not only did he know Albert Einstein, but he was a friend of Mark Twain. And I've probably mentioned this before. And I think he influenced one of Mark Twain's, one of his last works called Mysterious Stranger. My favorite book of all time, even though it's unpublished. Couple of things. First off, the Jeffrey Grupp, G-R-U-P-P, challenge is still in effect. Any scientist, pseudoscientist, anybody that wants to go out, a debunker, professional debunker, if you want to go out against Flat Earth, I got a guy that's just waiting to debate you. His name's Jeffrey Grupp from Zeteticism.com. I've been putting this out there for months. Nobody has come forward to come against him, and just waiting. He's got a big brain and a big head, a lot of horsepower up there. Nobody's doing it yet. But of course, the big news for today, and we'll talk about it at the top of the hour as well, and that is the Flat Earth International Conference 2017. It's going to be in Raleigh, North Carolina. And I'm looking, you guys want to talk about this tonight? Love to chat it up with you. If you go to fe2017.com, it's a big website built by Robbie Davidson of Celebrate Truth and Brian Mullen from Force the Line and several other things. And there's going to be a whole bunch of people there. I'm just rattling off the ones, I'm just scrolling down. Rob Skiba from this network, Odd TV is going to be there. Patricia Steer. Me, Jaron Campanella from Jaronism, Globusters, Bob Nodel, Jonathan Christopoulos, I never get a chance to say his last name, otherwise known as the Morgyle, Robbie Davidson, of course, Emmanuel Lakonga from Controversy 7. How many more people are on this thing? Scrolling down, oh, Richard Hopkins, Mr. Thrive and Survive, Amy Denise from Simply Seeking Truth, and Carly Madrano otherwise known as Carly Sunshine. It's going to be really great. It's November 9th and 10th in Raleigh, North Carolina. But if you guys want all the information on this, you guys can call in and ask questions if you want. I try to answer what I can. It is at fe2017.com. And it's going to be a great, great time. I encourage anyone that can go, please go. You got plenty of time to prepare for it. Wild horses could not keep me away from this thing. NDT with a gun in each hand could not keep me away from this thing. So please, by all means, check it out if you get a chance. Phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. This will be a call-in show, and I'm pretty darn sure it's going to work. So please do call in. I will answer them first come, first served. And remember, operators are standing by. By that, I mean me. So be nice, because no matter where you go, there you are. And while we are waiting for those first phone calls, let's go straight to the emails. This first email is from John. Dear Mark Sargent, I am an American living in Tokyo, Japan. I've been enjoying your videos and have been watching them with great interest. I'm not exactly sure how I stumbled on your YouTube channel. I can only guess one of your videos must have been listed on the sidebar of related videos. I cannot consider myself a flat earther. I'm not even sure of the spelling yet. Good point. But I'm getting closer with every passing day. A week or so ago, I was listening to your interview on Coast to Coast. Well, I think it was that program. But I see that you or someone else removed it because of copyright infringement. Is there any way I can listen to that interview? Also, what do you think of the work of Eric Dubé? Thank you for your time. Warmly, John Mancuso. John, I know you're kind of new to this, so hopefully you're listening, and maybe I'll respond to this in the email as well. Yes, the Coast to Coast interview was taken down briefly, but it wasn't because of copyright infringement. It was because Coast to Coast and George Norrie thought I had actually put the interview up on YouTube. And all I did was I put a 60-second clip of me talking, not on the show, just of me doing a narrative saying, look, Coast to Coast made me sign a waiver saying I wouldn't reproduce it. So therefore, if you want to listen to it, you're going to have to find it somewhere else or go to Coast and pay to have the archives and have access to the archives. And they obviously didn't listen to that 60 seconds. They just struck it, and I had it overturned within a couple weeks. But it was interesting and ironic because it was literally the only interview I hadn't reposted. They were the only guys that actually made me sign a waiver saying that not only can I not reproduce it, but anything that I say on their show, they can chop up and edit in any way they want. I have no say. Which, that's fine. I'll deal with that. So as far as what I think of the work of Eric Dubé, I think that most of his work is very good. I think his flat earth stuff is excellent. Do I like him targeting demographic groups and going after them? No, of course not. Everybody's got their own thing. Everybody's got their own side thing. But for me, it's all flat earth. And for Eric, he's got some other projects he's working on. But for the basically, hey, he's got 70,000 plus subscribers and he's doing really well. He's over in Thailand doing his thing. I honestly hope he could bury the hatchet and go to the conference in Raleigh. I really do. I know the invitation was put out to him, and he was one of a very short list of people, the other one being Matt Boylan. Eric didn't respond as far as I know, but Matt said he wasn't really interested right now. Now, hopefully Matt will change his mind. He's got too many flat earthers in his immediate area and circles that I hope he changes his mind and goes, because I think he'd be a benefit no matter what. But if he doesn't, that's fine. I think it's a missed opportunity. But as far as Eric goes, I have put out the olive branch to him several times. He will not email me back. He won't respond to my comments. My phone, I am the easiest guy to find in the world, and he won't contact me. So whatever Eric wants to do, whatever he's dealing with, eventually he'll have to work through that. But thank you, John, for that email. Next one is from Bill. Bill says, sir, I have recently gone down the rabbit hole of the Flat Earth Information Collective. I've been awake for 20 plus years to many of the lies on which our very lives have been perpetrated, but this one really is the grand scam of all time. Indeed. It is difficult to find a coherent, logical collection, dissertation, or explanation of the entire cover-up in one single volume. Also true. You seem to have done a good job at this attempt with the documentary film called Under the Dome, also known as the Flat Earth Clues Collection. Do you know of any sources to which you can refer to me that have actual untouched high-altitude photographs of the Earth? What about any interviews or film or just audio source where a high-level individual admits the truth of this reality? No, not yet. We're waiting. I mean, I've got subject matter experts, but the brass ring, of course, is somebody coming from NASA and basically ruining their career or what's left of their legacy and saying, yep, that's not what you think it is. He goes on and says, also, any other types of proof that the average layperson can understand that I can use as a teaching tool to open more eyes? Lastly, is it known at all or merely speculated, suspected as to the origin of the who or what? First phone call of the evening is coming in from 704. Let's try it out. You are on live with Strange World. Who are you? Where are you calling from?
Hey, Mark, this is Flip. I am calling from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Holy smoke, Charlotte, North Carolina. And since you probably heard that North Carolina is going to be the site of the 2017 Flat Earth International Convention, are you thinking about going?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, right on.
Absolutely.
How far
right
is
now, I'm looking forward to
how far is Charlotte from Raleigh?
Roughly 3 hours.
Oh, that's not bad.
Two and a half, three. So
good.
Yeah, won't be a problem getting up there.
Cool.
Oh, man, I'm curious. I'm looking forward to meeting, Rob, you, Jared. But I'm curious, is Mark from New York going to be there?
Oh, he's absolutely going to be there. And not only is he going to be there, but he's going to be driving his Chrysler 300 with the New York plate, "It is flat," on it.
Got it. All right. We'll have to look forward to meeting him, too.
Yeah. It's going to be great. I would imagine, since it's an East Coast thing, I would imagine quite a few people are going to be driving their flatmobiles down for it. I'm not going to, because I'm literally the exact opposite end of the country. So I'm not driving cross-country just so I can show off my plate. But I my plates will be there in spirit, definitely.
I hear you.
So that's awesome. So did you already look at the website and see what the lineup was?
I haven't seen the lineup. Only thing I checked was ticket price or the admission and all that stuff. That's gotcha. The only thing I've checked so far.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much, from what I can tell, everybody that has been doing hardcore videos for the last couple of years is going to be there. The only two people, if you heard the first part of the show, that have and by the way, I see 216 area code. You're going to have to wait till this call's gone. The only two people that have kind of shied away from it right now are, you know, Math Powerland from the NASA channel and Eric Dubay. And I don't know if Eric has even responded yet. I wouldn't imagine, since he's kind of on his own island, but who knows? But everybody else is going.
Yeah, I did see – I didn't look at the whole lineup. What was it I seen? Oh, I think it was Rob. He posted on Facebook a trailer for it or something like that, a little promo for it.
Yeah, Rob
Skiba. That's where I seen it was coming.
Rob Skiba did – he didn't do that trailer. That trailer was done by Robbie Davidson of Celebrate Truth. And I don't know if Controversy 7 had any help in that. But that was it was a cool little teaser trailer. And then I did one – I'm going to do one every week. Just kind of like a 3-minute trailer listing everyone that's going to be there. And if the news changes on what's going on, I'll list that in the video, but I'm literally going to do one every week.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah.
Good deal.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm pumped, man. It's too bad. We got to wait till November.
I know, but at the same time, it's a great goal for everyone to look at throughout the year. And I know I see you 216 area code. I promise. I'll tell you what. I'll be on just another minute with this guy. Holy smokes! Some people. But at the same time, it almost gives everyone no excuse because it's before the holidays, and if you want to save up money, you got 8 or 9 months to save up for it. If it's worth something to you, and it's cool. I totally dig it. And plus, it gives everyone a chance to think of creative things to do beforehand.
My only question is this.
Yeah.
Well, it's not my only question, but my main question right now. On the 9th, the night of the 9th, that's in between the 2 days, or on the night of the 10th, is there going to be a flat earth, like, giant conference mixer going on?
Oh, yeah. There's going to be, from what I understand, there's going to be a mixer happening on the first night and the second night. And it shouldn't be a surprise, because the last event on the 10th is the Flat Earth Award Show.
Good deal.
So Patricia and I are going to be hosting that, and we'll probably run a little long, like all award shows. But after that, I'm probably going to stay the weekend. So,
good deal. I hope you enjoyed it. Enjoy it out here.
I do too. It's been a while since I've been out to North Carolina, but I'm super excited.
Yeah, just be careful which bathroom you go into. You'll be all right.
Nice. All right, man. Anything else?
Just one quick question. Do you know, or maybe if anybody's listening knows, is there a website or some software out there where you can track the current position of the moon, like where it would be over the continental United States, or not over the United States, but, you know, around the world, wherever it's at, like if it's over Mexico or anything like that?
I'm not going to type it in right now, but if I had to take a guess, I would just go to any Google search and type in moon locator. Or real time moon location, or real time lunar locator, one of those. And there's got to be like half a dozen different locators out there.
Okay.
Just type that into Google. They'll find it for you.
Yeah, I'll make this real quick. And I got an idea of how to measure the height of the moon using triangulation.
Oh, cool.
But I've got there's two ways of doing it. One, if I can find a way that they already know where it's going to be, you know, exactly where it's directly above, well, then that makes it easy. But if not, I'll have to have some help and get some people around the country where I have to shoot and figure out where this thing is. So.
Got it. In fact, the Peanut Gallery just sent me a link. He went to mooncalc.org, mooncalc.org. Catch that? You hear me?
Hey, Mark. I just dropped you for a second.
That's okay. So
give me that website one more time.
Mooncalc.org. mooncalc.org.
Okay.
All right.
I will definitely look that up. Cool. I appreciate it.
All right, man. Hey, you have a good night, okay?
Yeah, you too, bro.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. Whoever was calling in from 216 area code, now you're going to have to wait because 646 just beat you to it. I'm so sorry. You are on Live with Strange World. Where are you calling from?
Hi, my name is Barrington.
I'm sorry, where?
Oh, New York. My name is Barrington.
Oh, hey, what's going on, man?
First time, long time listener, Mark.
Long time listener, first time caller?
Yeah.
Did I get it wrong? Don't be nervous. Seriously, do not be nervous. It's just you and me and whoever out there is listening. So it's not a big deal. What's on your mind this evening?
A couple of things. I just want to let you know I decided to go into the Navy because of you.
The Navy?
Yes. I'm currently in the process of enlisting.
Have I been recruiting for the Navy recently?
No. It's just when you had that guy on the Navy on, he really inspired me, the missile instructor.
Oh, yeah. Sean McCurry. He's a good guy.
Yeah, so I'm just really trying to – maybe I can figure some stuff out if I go out there myself. Who
sure,
knows? Maybe I'll
not?
Get stationed in the South Pole.
The Navy the Navy is not a bad – yeah, if you're going to – I mean, other than the Air Force, but, I mean, unless you're going to be a pilot, the Navy's got your best odds of figuring something out. Sure, why not?
Yeah. Oh, and your other guy, Mark, that's from New York, I got into contact with him, too. He's pretty cool. I spoke to him over Xbox Live. He's a pretty nice guy.
Yeah,
cool. He had a lot to talk about.
Cool guy, definitely.
Yeah.
Hang on. What 216 area code. I know I took another call, but you're going to have to wait. I'm sorry. Your timing's terrible. Anyway, this guy's called like 8 times.
All right. I wasn't even expecting to get through.
you lucked out. I mean, seriously, I hang up and it's like, okay, 216, call in. Then you snuck in right there. That's fine. So are you, you got any opinion? You thinking about maybe coming to the conference in the fall? Or are you going to be shipped out by then?
Well, my recruiter said I'll be in MEPS first week of March. So I have no idea how long the training is going to be. It could be up to 9 months, and then I can come home and have a little bit of freedom. But
well, if you think about it, it's the first week of November or the end of the first week of November.
So okay,
you
all
got plenty of time, but it'd be cool. So I'm glad to get, you know, again, Navy sounds like a fun thing, but if you're going to go, you know, whatever your specialty is, you know, make sure it has something to do with something long distance, like optics or targeting solutions, something like that.
Okay.
But I don't know.
I did pretty well on the ASVAB, so I could.
Whatever your career choice is there, you know, it's still ultimately your decision. But if you're looking for fun ways to try to prove this, that would be, you know, something you want to get into. Definitely not like gear mechanics. And
I wanted to either do something on an aircraft carrier or maybe submarine, but I wasn't completely sure.
I mean, submarines would be kind of cool. It's not for everybody, but
well, that's what everyone says. It's not for everyone.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's cool.
I just want to say I love the show. I listen to you almost every week. I don't always get to catch it live, but I catch it on YouTube.
Oh, thank you. That's wonderful to hear. And I'm just going to keep doing this thing as long as they let me. So it's, you know, I didn't ask for the show. I didn't ask for anything. I just said, hey, you know what? I don't think the Earth is round or a sphere. And thought for sure it would be someone would prove me wrong, but they haven't. So I'm just gonna keep going.
I thought someone would also, but you know, I got into it by it came up on my YouTube list. I was like, what is this? Let me just check it out, and then I've been hooked.
Nice. Awesome. I'm gonna try to squeeze in this 216. So any shout outs before I send you off into the night?
Shout out to Mark from New York.
Oh, cool. All right. Hopefully you're listening, Mark. I know he's getting ready for the conference way, way in advance. So cool, man. Well, hey, you have a good one, and maybe I'll talk to you soon.
All right. Thank you. Have a good show.
All right. Thanks, man. Have a good night. All right. Phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. And yes, 216. Oh, there you go. All right, 216. You're on the air, so make sure you turn down your radio.
All right. Hey, how's it going?
Good. Where are you calling from?
I am calling from the Cleveland, Ohio area.
Right on.
So I found out about the whole flat Earth concept.
Yeah.
Probably in like the third grade.
Okay.
And they were teaching us, you know, that people used to actually believe that, like before Columbus, like sailed the blue in 1492.
Oh, yeah.
And then, you know, like they pretty much put that to rest, you know, in my young impressionable mind. So about a year ago, my brother brought it up to me.
Yeah.
We were just talking about like conspiracy stuff. We talk a lot about that stuff.
Yeah.
And he brought it up and I laughed at him and I was like, dude, you're crazy, you know, and I never looked into it until probably 4 months ago. And just like everybody else, you know, you hear the stories now, like.
Oh, yeah.
I started researching and I'm like, what the hell?
Oh, yeah.
Like, what is going on? Like, I mean, it's just, you know, there's so much evidence out there. And so I started talking to people I know that fly airplanes.
Yeah.
You know, and they're like, well, I've never seen the curve. I've been, you know, 60,000 feet in the air. I haven't seen it.
Yeah.
And I guess the consensus in the scientific community is you can't see the curve until you get to about 60,000 feet. Well, I happen to know like airline pilots and I know people in the Air Force, and they say they've been 60,000 feet and some and haven't seen it themselves.
Yeah.
But they're still not saying that the Earth is flat, you know?
Oh, yeah. Well, and why so, would you? Yeah.
Right, right. So, and another thing, you know how I don't know how many thousands of years, like, they claimed you could see a ship going over the horizon,
yep,
you know, and disappearing.
Yep.
And I debunked that myself. You know, I've seen, like, I've looked through a pair of binoculars and seen, you know, the ship reappear.
Yeah.
And if you can't see the curvature of the Earth until you get to 60,000 feet, how could you ever see it on the ground?
Exactly.
You know, and I was showing my younger sister, you know, just maybe an hour ago, like, I just put my two fingers on a ball and I said, like, look, if you're standing at any point on a ball, you know, the the horizon of the ball will drop away from you.
Yeah.
And I said, but if you look anywhere where you have a clear field of sight for, you know, a long distance, you'll see that the horizon always comes to your eye level.
Yeah.
You know, and she was like, wow, but you know, that makes sense, you know, and just that little bit of evidence probably has her a little intrigued.
Oh, sure. Sure.
But another thing I wanted to bring up was like one of the major, you know, things about the flat earth theory is they say that, like access to Antarctica is restricted.
Right.
So, I got to searching around and I actually want to try to take a trip to Antarctica. I mean, they say it's not impossible. It's not one, you know, it's not an easy place to get to. And, you know, the best route would be like from a plane from New Zealand or something, but they said like, it's going to cost in the tens of thousands of dollars.
Oh yeah.
So I actually plan on doing that because, you know, if, you know, for 6 months of the year the Earth's axis is like, you know, tilted one way and then the other way, right? When
right.
it goes around the sun, supposedly. Right. And so, right, that makes, you know, the sun is going to like for 6 months out of the year, isn't going to be out more in Antarctica, or, you know, it's going to have like a smaller rotation or something like that. And it's not going to set all the way.
Good point.
So, like, if I could actually see that myself, now who knows where they take you to? You know what I mean? Like,
right.
you could be anywhere.
Anywhere.
You know. And as far as I know, this has been confirmed from a lot of people I know that sail that GPS doesn't in certain areas in the ocean.
Yeah.
And like sometimes it's attributed to like phenomena like the Bermuda Triangle. You know what I mean?
Yep.
So. Like, who knows where they take you, but I should be able to tell based on the sun, where the sun is, right?
Stop for a second. We're going to go to break. Stay on, okay?
Okay.
Stay on, but it's going to be 3 minutes, okay?
All right, that's fine.
No hate, no hype, no fear. We are DFR, your protection from deception.
Back to Strange World part 2 of 4. And are you still there, caller?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, tell you what, I'll give you another 5 minutes. Where do we leave off?
We left off, we're talking about travel Antarctica and traveling.
Perfect.
There
Antarctica, because you were talking about the sun, and it does cost quite a bit of money. I mean, if you're willing to spend, I mean, I think a minimum it's 10 grand to get down there.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, I don't know how far inland they would let you go, because most of the time they're going to take you to the outer islands, the peninsula that's south
right.
of Chile.
Like Rossi and, the South Pole is like, the thing is everything I've researched said there's nothing really stopping you from going to the South Pole.
Oh no.
This is my research and it's very limited, you know, so. But they're saying, like, with enough funding, the consensus is with enough funding, you can get there, you know?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Maybe it's $1 million or something, you know, and maybe you sign some type of disclaimer or something, you know?
There's multiple.
You have a tour guide that takes you, you know? Who knows?
Exactly. There's multiple permits you have to go through from different countries because, of course, nobody owns Antarctica, which is in itself very strange. Find me another piece of land anywhere in the world that nobody owns. We own everything. Every piece of land is marked off and owned by somebody. But the part, it's not the individual. People have said that. It's like, oh, I can totally go to Antarctica. It's, yeah, you can. But if you own a company, they cannot go. And you're saying, well, so what's the big deal about it? I'm going, no company. I don't care. That's where everything goes wrong. Because it doesn't matter how powerful, how influential your company is. You cannot bribe enough people to go down there. And that's impossible. You can bribe anybody to do anything in this world. That's just how it works. Greed and power and money. That's what rules everything. So why can't the oil companies go there? Why can't mineral companies go there? Why can't any of the government subcontractors set up shop there. And that's the part, again, it's I just kind of stumbled across it, and it generated a lot of suspicion with a whole bunch of people. So anyway.
Right. I mean, it perfectly makes sense. They're hiding something, like, yeah. Because, I mean, they don't, you know, it's nothing about, there's really no morals when it comes to money. Like, yeah. There are, you know, everything is subjective. I mean, just look at how pretty much the whole world is, like, raped Africa for, I don't know, how many years, like, you know, for resources. And, you know, yeah. Look at what we did to Afghanistan. I mean, all the lithium. Like, I'm talking on a cell phone, was listening, you know, to your radio show on another cell phone. I've got, you know, iPads and tablets. Those all wouldn't have been possible without the resources we got from Afghanistan, you know.
Sure,
so,
sure.
Like, I understand that. So it makes a lot of sense. It's just like, you know, I'm the type of person that before, you know, I accept an idea, I have to, like, see it. It has to be tangible. It has to be something I can see with my own eyes, something right. I feel and I can touch. And, like, I have the motivation right now to set up some kind of fund just to get me down there. And one thing I...
Lost you. You still there? You faded for a second.
Quadcopters and stuff?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yeah, so I'm a big fan of quadcopters and drones, and I know that they said, like, oh, if you're planning on taking a drone down to Antarctica, don't, because they're not going to let you fly it down there.
Yeah, and that, and
I
just,
thought that was
just
very odd. Like,
yeah, that happened about a year and a half ago when they put that into place.
Yeah, and it's like there's no flights over Antarctica, so it's not like you got to worry about air traffic or anything, you know.
Yeah.
Like, the FAA just put up their guidelines recently, you know, in the past year or so, maybe yep. less, about, you know, even for a hobbyist, you're not allowed, actually, I think commercially too, you're not allowed to fly a drone over 400 feet.
Right.
Where down there, there's no air traffic. You should be able to fly it to outer space if you wanted to, you know. But yeah, I thought that was really weird. And they were saying something about disturbing the wildlife, but it's like, if they're going to let you there, your very presence is disturbing the wildlife. So,
yeah,
that doesn't add up.
No, penguins don't care that you're there. I mean, that Orthodox priest went down there, and he was just walking in the middle of them. They don't even care. They're completely not domesticated. They just don't. Human beings aren't really a factor to them. So, hey,
yeah.
To get this to you, but unfortunately, I do have to do some other calls.
Oh, that's perfectly
stuff.
Fine.
What do you want any shout outs before you go?
No, that's all right. Nobody believes me that Earth is flat yet. I'll give it a little bit of time. I'll get some people to tune in for you, though, Mark. Thanks for taking me.
Oh, no worries, man. And call back again, okay?
All right, I will. Bye.
All right, see you, bye. All right, phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. That is 720-897-6111. Let's go back to the emails. This one's from Amin Kazura. He's an IT architect. And he says, hey, Mark, I really enjoyed watching your YouTube video. Probably the two-hour mashup thing. It was great and actually filled up some of the gaps. The truth is, I never really cared to know whether we live on a flat or round Earth. I was researching a different area, which is base reality versus simulated reality. But I now see the connection. A base reality is what we think we live in, the physical world, and a simulated reality is a computer-generated video game, virtual world. My theory is that we are living in a simulation program that has both sky and ground boundary limits. The limits are 80 miles up and 8 miles down. My two main reasons for this theory are, one, the double slit experiment proves that everything we know about science is wrong. I totally agree with you there. Two, our three-letter DNA codes offer 64 different combinations or amino acids, like computer code, like 64-bit. The questions I'm still researching are, one, I know someone or something created us. Who is it? Two, why were we created? I like your answer, creative force and art. It's a form of entertainment. It's sort of a form of entertainment. It's more like a form of novelty, a little different than entertainment, but it'll fit. Three, why are government agencies hiding this info? I assume they have a good reason with good intentions. Four, could there be more continents outside the Antarctic Circle and we can get to them? Attached images. Five, was God a computer programmer, an architect, or both? Programming does, I think, fit into this. Was God a coder? Again, why not? before there was coding, we would have thought that God used tools, divine hammers and chisels and screwdrivers and stuff. But now that we've got advanced software programs, why wouldn't it be code? Movies and shows with flat earth dome hints, Truman Show, Snowpiercer, Men in Black, Ascension, and he mentions what they were all in, and yes, I agree with all those. Movie with simulated reality hints, Tron, both old and new, The 13th Floor, and The Matrix Trilogy. Good. He's got them all down. I would love to get your feedback on this topic. I'm looking forward to hearing from you, Amin Kazura, IT architect. Awesome. Amin, let's get back to another email. I'm going to save that one because I may just email him and say that I talked about it on the show. This one's from Peter. Mark, how do you do? My name is Peter. Question one, if NDT says the Earth is now pear-shaped and a little chubby, does this mean that property lines have changed? Do surveyors need to go out and resurvey all boundaries? Do people now own more land than they used to? I will answer that one before I get to the second question. Two types of surveyors in the world. 95% of them are planar surveyors, P-L-A-N-A-R, which, not surprisingly, means that all their projects are based off of a plane. As a matter of fact, if you read the details on a planar surveyor, they treat the world and their project like the world is absolutely perfectly flat. So no, and that's 95% of all. Anything below, I think, 200 square miles in terms of a parcel is done by a planar surveyor. Now, anything bigger than that, which is usually like a park, a state park, is geodetic surveyors. And 845 is calling in. Let's see what he's got to say. You are on live with Strange World. Where are you calling from?
Hey, it's Mark from New York. What's up?
Hey, man. What's going on?
Hey, I wanted to say that you're... Pizza Planet thing is absolutely ridiculous. How can you go around the crust?
you heard that. I am totally of course that's that was the Boston interview.
Yes.
Yeah, the Boston interview. I have really tried to avoid using food references when it comes to describing the world. You know, because people don't take food as serious. Food is not necessarily a serious thing unless you're a chef. And so if I say pizza or Oreo cookie or I don't know, take any, you know, I'll say dinner plate all day long, but I generally will avoid pizza. Yeah. But the whole West thing was driving me nuts, but it was my fault because I didn't, and people have corrected me on this because you heard me. I was like going, look, which way you go, you know, you're going to run into Antarctica. But what I forgot to mention was that magnetic north in the center will always steer you in a circle.
Right.
So that that's where I think he was getting lost. But then again, he kind of threw me because he's going, no, there's you if Antarctica is one edge, then what are the other three edges? And I'm going, no, Antarctica is all the edges. He's going, no, you don't get me. You know, what if you keep going west? What about west? I'm going, it's Antarctica. I don't care north, south, east, west. You're always going to hit Antarctica. But it didn't really matter. He was just driving me insane.
Spoke on a bicycle wheel, you know, follow the spoke out from the center to the edge. If you go straight out from the center to the edge, of course, you
right.
Or the wall. Or
right.
Yeah, that was good. That was very entertaining. I liked it.
I was more interested in the host, I can't remember the name. Wait, the Boston interview. Where he had never done a conspiracy show before, and he'd been doing radio for a bunch of years on talk news radio, and he'd never done conspiracies. So I was trying to figure out how in the world he got to me, and I couldn't because we didn't have a pre-show or a post-show. But I would have asked him, like, "What are you doing? This is so far outside your wheelhouse. You're going to get a nosebleed for a week to 10 days." So
yes.
What are you doing? But because you could tell, I mean, plus he wasn't a science oriented guy. This is a guy that would be in red carpet lines interviewing Beyonce. And, you know, he was an interviewer, a music interviewer. And he didn't know, like, for example, if you heard it, he didn't even know what the ISS stood for.
Yeah. Is that terrorist organization?
Yeah. I was having to clarify quite a few terms. But his callers kept it interesting. So, and it's still, honestly, after the shady 45 interview, there's never going to be any callers worse than that. So I think I can handle. By the way, the peanut gallery has got a quote for you already.
Oh, okay, I got one for him.
Okay, clothes make the man. Naked people have little or no influence on society. That's from Mark Twain.
That's superb.
And reader, suppose you were an idiot and suppose you were a member of Congress, but I repeat myself. That's Mark Twain also. And the host's name, by the way, was Bradley J. Thank you, Peanut Gallery. All right, what do you got? You got something?
I really think he was on your side. I mean, he kept trying to clarify it to the callers, what you were explaining. He might be a closet.
He might be.
I don't know.
It might be. I'm glad he did it, and he didn't attack me too far, and he let me run the entire 2 hours. Well, he didn't let me run. But what happened was, with a lot of people that take call-ins, you know, he does a late-night news talk show. So once the phone line started exploding, he was like, well, I got to get through these as fast as I can. So he's like, okay, he's answered your question. Okay, let's move on. Okay. So people are going, Mark, you sound rushed. I was like, of course I was rushed. The host was freaking out. So he didn't know what to do. Like, holy smokes, I have 10 times the amount of callers. Anyway, go ahead.
All right. Where to go?
Go ahead.
Change is the law of life, and those who look only to the past or present are certain to miss the future. That was JFK.
Nice.
And I think it's appropriate for this year, because we have the conference, people are getting together, you know, we're all the same. That guy from North Carolina, I didn't get his name, but
it's awesome.
You know, well, I mean, we're all the same. We want to talk to people and see other people in the flesh and be like, you know what? I am not that shit crazy. This is awesome.
No, when I went to the Souk event out here in Canada, and it was much smaller, not really publicized. I just went because it was right down the road. It was interesting to me because it felt like, I wasn't kidding when I said this before, it felt like an AA meeting where people just were happy to be in a room with other people that weren't gonna come down on them. You know, they might as well have opened up. Like, hello, my name is John, and I'm a flat earther. Hello, John. You know.
That's, no, I don't. I hope nothing like that. No, please.
No. The energy is going to be huge when this conference happens. I mean, I am so pumped about this now. I'm probably not going to sleep a week before it happens because. It's,
oh yeah. I can't go. I'm not going to be able to go. No, kidding.
I'm about to say, you're lying through your teeth.
I might think that's the first night.
Do you know the VIP things have almost sold out already?
Oh, nice. Yeah, see, I was like, I'm buying that shit right now.
Yeah, good move, because I went to their website, and I think there was only like 5 left or 6 left as of today. And it's only been out for, 4 days on sale?
Yeah.
So, holy smokes. I mean, that's great. So now we have to see if we hit the levels of capacity. There's 3 different levels they can do for general admission. And I think a lot of closet people are going to be there. Other guys are like, how do you know? It's like, man, I just got this feeling. The sheer amount of emails that I get and the comments that I see on the videos and the phone calls, there's a lot of people out there that want to talk to other people about this. And on the East Coast, if it's within driving distance, forget about the planes. If it's in driving distance, people are going to make up excuses to go.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You're going to lie, cheat, steal. Everybody, you got to do that.
So I can't wait. Yeah, and, no doubt. And I'm, you know, there's so many things up in the air. What will the media response be? You know, will you have, it could be anything from just local news sending crews just to see if they're crazy to like Conan O'Brien sending a crew to see if everyone's crazy. Because why wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Once you get the word out that there's actually going to be a Flat Earth conference, morbid curiosity will set in with anybody in mainstream media. It's like, oh, dude, you got to send a team out there just to see, because they would expect people, you know, in costume and lots of actual tinfoil hats and black magic. And you bet it'll be
like a Comic-Con.
Yeah, it'll be. Okay. Yeah, people will be expecting Comic-Con, and it won't. Will not be that. It's going to be complete something completely different.
So. Yeah, it's good. I like the idea. Like I said, of just that I'm going to have the chance to be able to meet other people that are like-minded, and even without the flat Earth, we obviously don't think alike and look at things like,
right.
Hey, that's kind of bullshit. What are they doing over there?
Oh yeah,
you know.
Yeah. Because again, how can you judge anybody in that room? And even like for example, I was kind of toying, messing with some other flat Earth people and saying that, you know, there's a chance that Lord Stephen Christ will show up. And I was thinking, you know what? Even if he did, that's still not bad because he doesn't believe in the globe. Now, granted, you know, he'll make a bunch of noise. It's like concave Earth is the truth and I am the way, blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, he still doesn't like the globe. And that says something. So part of me thinks he should show up. Part of me.
I mean, that would be good if Eric and Matt show up too.
Well, I think Matt, between you and me and whoever's listening, I think Matt still may show. I think it's too big of an opportunity not for him to show up because, again, people, everyone knows. Look, I wouldn't have gotten into this hadn't I tried to disprove his story. Everybody knows that. I've said this on a million interviews. And as far as Eric goes, he should make peace. He should bury the hatchet and he should show up. And no one, he's not. Yeah. He'll have to eat a little crow, I think. But for the most part, everyone would be just happy to have him there. Like, look, dude, are you done playing King of the Castle? Come on. Get with the community. Hang out.
Joe Rogan should show up.
Yeah, he should. He should show up.
That would be, you know, I for some reason lately, I just been having this gut feeling like he's still a closet believer. But
I think he is too. But he's contractually obligated to not be. So he can't be officially. So I'd be neat if he did.
But he always brings it up, even if he's bringing it up in a bad way, he's still bringing it up.
Yeah.
So he'll make people talk about it. And, you know, that subconscious thing. Like, you know, it was weird. I was just looking at, because I was watching Planet of the Apes this weekend. And I was like, huh, those big movies back then, they started, everything was planet, and then it became star.
Yeah.
You know, and the movies are star. And I wonder if it was... Hey, you know, the subconscious, let's make them think about bigger than here. Don't worry about here. This is cool. Nothing to see here.
Yeah.
Look out there.
Yeah. Good one. Like it. Yeah, you're right. Star Trek, Star Wars, Stargate, Battlestar Galactica.
Yeah.
I mean, heck, those four franchises alone are freaking monstrous.
Right.
And that, and those just ones with star in the title. The rest of the science fiction groups still are deep space based. So yeah. I know. Well, I'm
sorry. I can't.
Sorry. Go ahead.
So I'm just so excited. I'm sorry.
I know.
It's like stock age five. You know, like I can't wait to meet everybody. You know.
I know.
It's like so many of you have opened my eyes to different things, and you know, and no way have I done all the experiments. Absolutely not. But I've tried some of the things and looked into them and actually researched them myself.
Yeah.
And holy shit, it's scary because it's true, you know, and don't take anybody's word for it. Do a little work for yourself. Not like these debunkers who do 30 seconds of research and then make a fool of themselves.
Yeah. I want to take one more call before the break, but before I let you go, if you want to check out a cool video tonight. If you haven't seen it already, check out the 7.5 laser test over the frozen lake that was just. Have you seen that? With the snowmobiles? That's brilliant.
Yes.
Yeah, let's attach lasers to a snowmobile or you know, one end and with a light, a high powered light on it. And that site, what was amazing was the guy that put that out, he's a gearhead. He's got 60,000 subscribers, and all he does is mechanical instruction videos. And all of a sudden, he became a flat earther. You know, he was into lasers, and he said, you know what, I think I could design a test for this. And he did, and it's perfect.
Yeah.
And there you go. Yep. There's your atmospheric conditions over the water, gone. It's at night in a perfectly, you know, there's no city lights to distort anything. There's no weird weather. He's the math looked good, and I think he nailed it.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Have somebody convince me now that's mirage. The light over a frozen lake where there's no heat waves at all. Tell me that's a mirage happening.
Too funny.
Anyway, funny. I got to run, man, but I will definitely talk to you soon, okay?
I'll say my email if anybody wants to contact.
Oh, yeah, me. Yeah. What's your email again?
Zulu01@yahoo.com.
Zulu01@yahoo.com. Okay.
Zulu01@yahoo.com.
All right. And that's right, Mark. Cool. That's Mark out in New York, everybody. So check him out.
Peace out, buddy. Oh, crap. I almost forgot.
What?
Barrington, what the hell? Man, he's the man. Oh, my God. I heard his voice. I was like, no shit, he's calling. Because he's, like you said, he can't listen live all the time.
Nice.
That's awesome. That was awesome. All right, cool.
All right, man.
Have a good one.
All right, see ya.
All right, good night.
All right, let's do okay. We'll take 778. You might have to stay through the break though, because we're running out of time. You're on Strange World with me. So, where are you calling from?
Hey, Mark.
Hey.
This is Daryl from across the water.
Hey, Daryl. What's going on? 347. You're gonna have to call back after the break because I'm gonna take Daryl at least to the break. What's
okay? Yeah.
What's happening?
North Carolina is what's happening, man.
Right on. I imagine you're
this
going.
This is so cool.
I know.
Yeah, I got my ticket already. I didn't get a VIP one. I guess I should have spent the extra $30.
Don't sweat it. It's going to be fun regardless. So
that $30 will go to a beer.
There you go.
Something.
There you go. You can get hammered after the fact. But definitely.
Yeah, it was.
Definitely find me while you're there, you know, a few times, because I'm going to be doing different things. But I think I'm going to attend every single – I'm not going to be talking in them, obviously, but I'm going to attend every single thing that's happening.
Yeah. So am I. That's what the plan is. We're even going to stay in the – whatever it is.
The hotel?
Like, obviously, it's at a hotel.
Right.
Yeah.
I think it's the Embassy Suites.
Yeah, and we're probably going to be there, like you were saying, like either the week before or for the weekend after. So.
Oh yeah, well I'm gonna try to show up the day before. So if it's on a Thursday, I'm gonna show up sometime Wednesday, and at the very least. But yeah, I think I'm gonna stay the weekend. So and leave maybe on Sunday.
Yeah, that area of the world is the world. That area of the what is it? The disc is very strange to me. I've never been there, so.
Oh, it's just it's just the middle of the East Coast. It's cool. It's pretty neat. So you'll have fun.
Yeah, well, I hear it's kind of touristy. What else was I gonna say to you?
Be quick. We're going to break.
I'm just really really stoked, man. It's gonna be great.
Right on. Yeah, I know.
I already got my ticket, book and flights.
Oh, yeah. I am going to hype this thing up as much as I can. I'm going to run promos every single week. I'm going to bring it on every Strange World show until we get there. And I'm super excited, you know, unless the world stops me. You know, nothing's going to keep me from this thing.
Well, let me know if you need any, like, After Effects work or 3D renders or whatever.
Oh, right. Yeah, keep through. Send me an email with what you might do. We got to go to break, though, okay, man?
Yeah, you got it. I'll talk to you soon.
Okay, see you, man.
Bye.
You are now tuned into the Truth Frequency.
We are TFR. TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
You better give Elmo and Charlie a flashback and buff everything up to condition ready to stand by tomorrow.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 3 of 4. And because it's the top of the hour, let us do a quick promo. My Flat Earth sites are barksargent.com for the subscription site, enclosedworld.com for the free site, and for the upcoming conference, if you guys haven't figured this out already, you can either go to YouTube and just type in Flat Earth Conference and set the filter to, you know, last week, or you can go to fe2017.com. That's fe2017.com. And register. You still got time for the early bird registry. I mean, this thing is until the fall. But the VIP things, if you want to get on the VIP, those things are going to be gone in the next couple days. Whatever's left. In fact, it probably will be gone day after tomorrow if I had to take a bet. And the Peanut Gallery also sent me, there is going to be a 2017 European Flat Earth Conference, which I didn't even know about till just now. And you can check that out at efeconference.weebly.com. And that would be interesting, Flat Earth Conference. In fact, it's a preparing the 2017 European tour, and I don't know much about it yet. Maybe I'll look during the break, but it says Amsterdam, Geneva, Rome, Cologne, Barcelona, and London. So good for them. Honestly, that's fantastic. Very, very cool. And in fact, when Peanut Gallery says there's only one VIP ticket left right now for North Carolina, holy smokes. That exceeded, I'm sure, their expectations. Yeah, why not? I mean, if you're going to spend the money to go out there, you know, spend the extra, I think it's an extra $100 to get the VIP thing. But that's awesome. That's fantastic. And everyone, you know, thank you very much for your support so far on that. And the phone number to call in, well, I make some awkward sounds because I'm holding the microphone between my legs as I try to type in the email. Anyway, the phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. That is 720-897-6111. And somebody wrote in and says, please promote my Niagara Falls, Canada meetup. Oh, this may be like one of the first meetups of the season. So let's before we do that, oh, Jesus, two calls have come in. Let's try 347 first. 347, you are on live with Strange World. Where are you calling from? What are we talking about?
Mr. Mark Sargent, this is Steven from Brooklyn, New York.
Hey, man, what's going on?
How you doing, bro?
I can't complain.
Yeah, I'm trying to call in. I'm sorry, but I'm on my phone, so it's like a little time delay, I guess.
That's okay. It's all right. do what you can. What's on your mind this evening?
Nothing, bro. Just flat earth, like always.
Nice. Hey, are you thinking about coming to the conference in the fall?
Oh, man, I would love to. I would love to. My wife's sister actually lives out there, and I would love to go out there. November, that's enough time, like you said.
Well,
I could start planning.
Again, it's in the fall, so you got time. But, I mean, I know at least a few people that are going to be driving down from New York.
Yeah, I know. I would love to. I got the app, though. I already registered and everything just in case, you know. But
all right.
That'd be great.
Cool. That's totally cool. So any shout-outs, any particular questions or topic you want to cover real quick?
Not really. I would just like to say that Flat Earth just kind of like changed my life after I discovered it maybe almost 2 years ago. And it just transformed my whole life, everything. Because as a kid, I grew up, I always wanted to be an astronaut. I loved space and science, and that was my life. I loved all that.
Yeah.
Until I just discovered this and kind of shattered my kind of whole life, everything.
Oh, dude, you know, I used to, because I used to collect a whole bunch of things, you know, that kind of gives away my age because I collected stuff. I used to collect antique globes. Antique Earth globes. That was one of my things. I loved them. I couldn't get enough of them. I love the whole iconic globe image. And now I literally don't own any of them. They're all gone. And I just can't look at them anymore. It's like, okay, I get it. They're beautiful. Well,
I'm sorry. I'm walking outside.
Anyway, Any shout outs you want to give? Because unfortunately, I've still got some calls. I've got to pick up.
Just to my sister. That's my fellow flat earther, my fellow truth seeker.
Right on.
My sister Mischief Tip. That's it. And everybody else, like my brothers, kind of stopped speaking to me and everything because they're thinking I'm crazy. I'm a conspiracy nut, I guess.
Well, you're not alone, man. There's a whole bunch of people that if you're crazy, then there's a lot of other crazy people out there. So
that's what I said, but you know, we make a noise and hopefully everybody open their eyes soon. And
I think so. I have no doubt 2017 is going to be a great flat year.
Me too. I believe so. Hopefully everything goes good though.
I think so. Anyway, man, hey, have a fun one and call in again. Okay.
Yes, sir. Next week. Definitely. I will.
Okay.
Have a good one, bro.
All right. See ya.
Yes,
bye bye. Phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. That was me trying to pretend to be a racehorse announcer. Ooh, and there's a call from 801 area code. 801, you are on live with Strange World. Where are you calling from? Don't be nervous. And what are we talking about?
I'm calling from Arizona. I'm on a here temporary visa from Utah. You know, like the conference thing, I was kind of calling about that. I see they have the VIP tickets and stuff like that, but it's clean in North Carolina, and it's kind of a long way, and I'm still thinking about doing the whole trip.
North Carolina, I will say this, because I wasn't the one that chose the location. It's not bad because for getting the most exposure, because most of the population center, I mean, yeah, you could go West Coast or you could go East Coast, but if you get East Coast, then you get the Midwest as well, potentially. And mm-hmm. I mean, there's a lot of population out there. So, and it's centrally located. So I don't blame you. I mean, look, I can't drive out there because I'm way in the Northwest of the United States, but
right.
Plenty of time to think about it. And, you know, yeah, the VIP tickets are going to sell out, but that's okay. You know, there's
I'm wondering if they're going to have booths or anything like that, because, you know, our church, you know, it's been a long, you know, 2010 is when we kind of, our church is like full geocentric and I mean, we were just we were banned from websites and all. I mean, just the whole thing is, and to see it grow to this now that, you know, you can actually talk about it and not get kicked off or, you know, and actually have some kind of dialogue. I know it's still tough, but in the olden days, in the, 7 years ago, it was just like, you were a lunatic is what it was. And it's really a blessing. Is this the first annual international
Well, I heard that they did one in the Netherlands last year, but I don't know. I don't know how successful it was, and I literally do not know anyone that went. Not knocking them. Look, it was in the Netherlands, and sometimes the Europeans, they do their own thing, and I just saw a thing that they're going to try to do one in 2017 where they're going to go to multiple cities, but I don't know who's going to be part of the group out there. I'll have to look it up and see what's going on. But yeah, this is definitely the biggest. This is going to be the biggest collection if you want to go for pure exposure.
I've seen the lineup. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
You know, I'm a little disappointed at Eric Dubé. Has he been asked or
he
rejected it or what?
Was it? From what I know, he was asked, but he has not responded. And I still have hope. Honestly, if he showed up to it, he would not be abused. Yeah, all the people would be like, "Hey, man, glad you could make it." Yeah,
he needs to come. He needs to. I hope he hears this. I love you, Eric, but you need to come to this.
I wouldn't care. I mean, I remember his enemies list is still up on his IFRS site, and I'm still number one with a bullet on his enemies list. I wouldn't care. It wouldn't be conditional. It's like, you can't come until you pull me down off the enemies list. I don't care. Just show up. I mean, you've got this massive subscriber base. Your fans are very loyal. And so why not?
I love you both. And I I'm bewildered. I don't see what the whole thing is. I know.
Do you want me to tell people. You? Here, give me 60 seconds. I'll tell you exactly what happened. The division between Eric and I happened almost immediately, and that was because I did an interview with Lisa Harrison. It was one, like my third interview. And all of a sudden, one of his people contacted me and said, Eric's upset with you. I go, okay, why? And they said, well, because you're doing two things that he doesn't like. I go, okay, what are they? And he said, well, first, you're kind of going towards the Orlando Ferguson map, which is not a perfect flatness. It's kind of like a hubcap thing. And second, you're mentioning Crow 777. I go, so what if I'm mentioning Crow 777? He goes, well, Crow isn't a flat earther. And I go, who cares? He's got the best moon footage. And I've been adamant. And I said, look, if anyone gives me better moon footage than Crow 777, I'll use it. And but it got me. It's like, look, your videos were out 2 months before mine. It's not like I have to ask permission to do what I'm doing. And he immediately said, well, obviously Mark is a shill. And he was the one that started the rumor. And I was like, come on. And he wouldn't back down from that, even now. So everyone that's a follower of Eric thinks that I work for the government because I wouldn't listen to Eric's advice. And it's like, it's fine. I get it. Some people are sensitive about that stuff. And
well, you know what? They say time heals all wounds. So hopefully some water gets under the bridge and this thing, he needs to come to this thing.
He absolutely does need to come to this thing. If he
hey, one other thing before, you know, I won't see the other people coming.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. I'm looking at this whole Antarctic thing right here.
Yeah.
And so I'm thinking, okay, let's say the ice extends beyond what we see on the on our flat earth maps,
right?
And it and there is continents out above there, but what had happened is the sun used to make a wider circle. So at one time there was an ice age in more in the center of the North Pole and down to the North America. You know, there's signs of ice age and stuff like that. Supposedly. Okay, so the sun was a larger circle, so all the Antarctic could have been a livable area at that time. There could have been continents. There could have been civilizations before the Great Flood or whatever it was, you know, that disrupted the what it was. And so I'm wondering if they're down there and they're starting to find, you know, evidences of civilization, like maybe, they're talking about pyramids or even whole cities and stuff like that.
Why not? I mean, if you're going to hide a civilization, that's the only place you really can put it right now, unless you go underground.
Well, it seems logical. I mean, all the sun had to do was have a bigger circle.
Yeah.
And that's not out of the plausibility. I mean, they're finding animals who have actually grass in their mouth and stuff like that. It were frozen almost instantly.
Yeah.
So it does kind of point to some catastrophic event that actually happened. But one of my new things saying is that people say, well, prove there is a God. I says, the world's flat.
Yeah.
And if they can grasp hold of that, which eventually they will, if they're really a truth seeker, they'll start believing in God. So as a pastor, that's kind of one of my things, because I've been, you know, the Bible is explicitly geocentric, without a doubt, undisputable. Christians have always believed the world is flat.
Yeah.
And well, that's my two bits tonight.
Okay.
I appreciate you. I do have my flat, it is flat license plate in Utah. You've seen it before. You've
right. Shown it up I love it. Before. I love it, man. Well, yeah, you're going to be seeing that all the time now. It's going to be pretty much in rotation.
So. Hey, I love you, man. Keep it up. I love everything you're doing. You're doing
a great
job.
All right.
All right. Talk to you later.
Have a good night.
All right. You too.
Bye-bye. Before we take the next call, I want to read this real fast so you guys don't call real fast, because there's somebody is going to be doing an event in March. So I want to get this out there. Please promote my Niagara Falls, Canada Flat Earth Meetup. Hello, Mark. Feel free to read this. My name is Brian on YouTube. Wes, put your freaking phone down. I see you. Do not call back right this second. On YouTube, I use Ginger Sugarbush 905. I was hoping you could help promote the meetup in Niagara Falls, Canada. I want to hold a meetup at the Niagara Falls Library on Victoria Street on Saturday, March 18th, 2017. If they boot us out of the library, there is always Tim Hortons across the street. 1 p.m. I don't actually know anyone who's open-minded enough to grasp the scale of the deception. That's why I can't wait for North Carolina in November. Yeah, there's going to be social events throughout the year. But the big conference is going to be in November. Just got to get a passport. I'm just going to try to call in, but who knows what will happen. Thanks and keep up the good work. If anyone wants to email him about the Niagara Falls mixer, we'll call it a meetup mixer, whatever you want to. It's going to be March 18th, and his email address is N as in Nancy, F as in Frank, F as in Frank, Edward, E as in Edward, 905@gmail.com. So NFFE 905@gmail.com. His name is Brian. And his YouTube channel is Ginger Sugarbush 905, which is a weird one. If anyone's in the Niagara Falls area and wants to do a meetup in March. So thank you for that. Okay, so you guys want to call in 720-8976. There we go. And you are on live with Strange World.
Hey, Mark, this is West Face, Flat Earth News. How are you doing?
Hey, Wes. Been a little while. What's going on?
Yeah, I wanted to ask one. I've been meaning to try to catch you on Patricia's show.
Sure.
Throwing in the comment here and there. But I wanted to find out why a lot of the Flat Earth community isn't talking more about, I mean, they usually talk a lot about Berg, which is great and everything, but they never mention a lot about Sean Picard. I mean, one of the first scientists who went up in a hot air balloon, the highest that anyone's went. And of course, you know, when he came down, he did mention that the Earth was flat.
Yeah, that it seemed like a flat disc with upturned edges on the side. Yeah, the reason why he didn't get as much press is because, well, one, Byrd was a United States admiral, and he was an explorer. Remember, Picard was really more of a vertical explorer, whereas Picard was a vertical explorer, whereas Byrd kind of went all over the place. He went to the North Pole in 1926 and then spent the rest of his life down in the Antarctica area for 30 years. So his body of work was bigger than Picard's. But yeah, Picard is a great one. In fact, I believe it's the Hennessy commercial, which I use in my the background stuff, because he had a grandson that was into deep sea, I think it was a son, deep sea submersibles. So they kind of did the whole pit, where one's going up and one's going down, and they're sort of linked in a way. But it was an interesting commercial, very, very interesting.
Yeah, it was an interesting commercial, but I think it was mocking us,
You think? Maybe? I don't know. I mean, it didn't seem like it was joking too much. I thought it was wonderful. It gave me chills the first time I saw it.
I thought it was great the first time I seen it, but then someone had mentioned that they were mocking the Flat Earth.
Well, maybe. Maybe. I think that writers and creative people out there nowadays are getting more used to the idea. And they know the topic's not going away. This is not – it'd be different if there was a lot of really, really eccentric people in the Flat Earth community, but it's the opposite of that. There are there's no people out there that really wear tin hats or have a weird song and dance that goes with it. Everybody's got their own personality, but for the most part, everyone's level-headed and professional. So that's why it's tough to really, because otherwise it'd be easier to pick on Flat Earth.
Sure. So I would just like to see more. I'd like to see more Flat Earthers talk about him.
Okay.
Because I think he was the number one guy. Even though they probably discredited him back then, and that's why he's not as famous as a lot of other.
Sure. Picard.
People.
Definitely he was the man. I think. What the man who way before the astronauts got up higher than anybody that was there.
Yeah.
So
absolutely.
Yeah. And he did.
All right, dude. That's all. I just wanted to add that.
Oh, thank you. That's awesome. Oh, and by the way, are you thinking about it in November? Thinking about it?
I'm thinking about it.
All right.
It's all about the cash.
I know. Well, hey, there's lots of time between now and then. Where are you anyway? You're out in.
I'm all over in Minnesota.
It's not that far. But, yeah, I hope, again, plenty of time between now and then, but I hope you can make it.
What was the time and where exactly?
Oh, it's November in North Carolina.
North Carolina. Yeah, I've been to North Carolina. So, yeah, that's a, yeah. Even if I drove it a few years ago, but I drove it with like two dogs, two cats, and a nagging woman. So it took me like, 3 days to get there. But anyhow,
nice.
I know that I could do it in 24 hours.
Got it. Well, again, plenty of time between now and then. Just, you know, consider it.
All right, man. We'll talk to you.
Okay. Bye-bye. Phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. And the Peanut Gallery is shooting me comments, and most of them you do not hear from that I actually mentioned it. But Peanut Gallery's last one says, oh, Picard, the guy in the Starship Enterprise. You know, I wonder if they named Jean-Luc Picard based on him. In fact, what do you bet? I bet you it's linked in some way. 912 calling in. 912, you are on live with Strange World. Where are you calling from? Don't be nervous. And who are you?
Hey, it's Seth. Called last week.
Oh, right on, man.
County, Massachusetts.
Cool. What's going on?
Got some cool info about the conference.
Sure, shoot.
Some reaction from the globe Earth side of things.
I can't wait.
Listening to some late night live streams.
Yeah.
I think it's called Earth Talks or Earth Discussions.
Oh no, they've already found out about it?
Yep, and they're mocking it like crazy.
Oh, I have no doubt. I would put real money that there's going to be news teams out there just hoping that somebody shows up in a tin hat or an alien costume or something that can, you know, because again, they would expect everyone that shows up to this to be certifiable, right? But it's the opposite. So yeah, and again, remember, this thing hasn't even been out a week yet, and there's people talking about it. That's awesome.
Yeah, so they were talking, you know, about their proofs of the globe and, you know, it's so obvious, and if you can't understand it, you're stupid. And I really have to say that they almost phrase it in a past tense in the kind of way like we didn't grow up in the same education system that they grew up in. It's like, oh, don't you know about gravity? I'm like, no, I never went to school.
Yeah. Yeah, they have forgotten the fact, but we have to point this out pretty much every time we get in a debate, that nobody starts out as a flat earther. Everybody attacks flat earth. And if you attack it well enough, if you try to, if you really sit down and try to break it down, that's when you fall for it. It's really, and I know this reference isn't going to mean much to people out on the East Coast, but it's La Brea tar pits, which is, you know, that soupy tar pit thing that where what would happen is like one of the cubs, like a dinosaur cub would fall into the tar pits. And then the parent would try to help. They'd get stuck. They'd get pulled in. And anybody that tried to help anybody out of the tar pits would get pulled in. And that's really what flat earth is. Everyone says, oh, yeah, well, you tried to debunk it, but you didn't do it right. You screwed it up. Therefore, I will help you debunk it. And that person gets pulled in. And then it's same. Everyone has this ego. It's like, well, if you can't prove the globe, you're an idiot. So I'm going to – obviously, I can do it. And you just watch it, just rinse and repeat. It happens over and over again, and I just love it. I love watching debunkers come after this.
Oh, they're taking it another level, which is, you know, if you're believing in flat earth, then you must be maladjusted, to the point where they're saying, oh, this is all for money. Everything's non-refundable. I doubt, like, they'll even get 10% occupancy because you know, nobody's interested. Flat earthers just aren't capable. They're not planning ahead, getting a plane ticket, putting aside the money. They just couldn't figure it out.
I mean, and talk about wrong. The VIP tickets, I'm pretty sure, are going to be sold out before this show is done. There was one left when we started the show, and this thing's only been, that's just the VIP section. Now, general admission, of course, there's plenty of tickets. But how many before, and I'll keep people posted if we hit certain milestones. People will show up. Here's one of the big reasons why there will be a lot of people showing up, because they want to feel vindicated for the, and we're going to be going to break here in about 90 seconds, just so you know, vindicated because of all the people around him that are against it. They will show up as like, I would love to, I hear this over and over already, which is, I want to be in a room with people who accept me. And here it is. You got an entire convention. You got 2 days of nothing but wall-to-wall people that are just like you. It'll be great. So anyway, we're going to be going to break in a sec. You got any shout-outs before we go?
Yeah, real quick. You know, on the world as a globe, everybody's a mechanism.
Yeah.
Not a real person. They might as well be a utility, but in the earth, everyone's a soul with a living being behind the eyes that, you know, hurts, feels, loves, is a real thing. And, you know, that's why my new motto now is flat love is better than globe love.
Perfect. And
so
with
shout out is to Murphy, my girlfriend. Love you, and hopefully good things will come.
Nice, man. Hey, have a good night, okay?
All right, take it easy.
See you, man.
Real people, real radio. Wherever you are, make it TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 4 of 4, and no peanut gallery. I am not going to sing with it, man. It's a good year. No, I'm not singing Joe Jackson yet. I don't think I can pull off Joe Jackson. His voice is a little higher than mine. But yes, that was Joe Jackson stepping out from his album, Night and Day. Last chance for you guys to call, and we've had a bunch of callers tonight. Thank you to everyone that has called in so far. I didn't do Flat Earth News during the last one because we were doing a whole bunch of other stuff. So I go into YouTube, I type in Flat Earth, I set filter to this week, and there's a whole bunch of stuff in there. Flat Earth asshole went to an open mic night and recorded the whole thing, 10 minutes of gold, just him throwing it out there at the crowd. Good for you, man. He brought his own television hooked up to, I don't know, his phone or a laptop or something. That was awesome. Great. Eric Dubé is reproducing Flat Earth Street interviews done by Dell, otherwise known as Dell from Scotland, otherwise known as, and I don't have his channel in front of me, but it's really, really good. And where Dell, this big Scottish guy, is just going to the streets. He's got a captive audience, not just because of the topic, but the guy looks like he's made out of a pile of bricks. And I wouldn't run away from him either. I think he's like, you know what? I'll give him a few minutes just so he doesn't pound me. And let's see, who else we got? Me. I did Flat Earth Clues interview 99 at tinfoilhatclub.com. Literally, tinfoilhatclub.com. Really chill interview. Love doing it. Much more relaxing than the Boston radio show interview where the guy was just freaking out because the phones were blowing up. The promo, of course, for the Flat Earth International Conference. I'm going to do one every week. Also, Flat Earth Asshole versus John B. Wells, round 3. And yes, Peanut Gallery mentioned that, even though I cut that part out at the beginning of the show, when the Tinfoil Hat Club interviewed me, even though he totally had my name right, and we'd been emailing each other, when he started the show, he called me Steve like 3 times. It's like, no, man, it's not Steve. Morgyle, David Seaman destroyed Flat Earth. Great one. Black Hole Interactive cranking them out. Flat Earth. People don't want to hear the truth because of something. I missed the back part of that. Black Hole Interactive again. Star Gods making a video here right against the convention. Flat Earth Cash Flow Convention in November. He actually thought, one, I was the one that was doing the convention. No, it was Robbie from Celebrate Truth and Brian Mullen. So I have nothing to do with the money side of this. And no, this is not a money grabbing opportunity. This is getting everyone together, and it is overdue. We should have done one in 2016. So happy to celebrate truth and everyone's being involved. And I hope that Matt comes and I hope Eric comes and we can get everyone that we can involved here. Second page, let's see. Antonio Subarets, Max Egan's flight proves the Earth is flat. Good. More black hole interactive. Flat Earth Poncho Pete, stronger than flat Earth, stronger. He keeps doing his hangouts, and they're 8 hours long. Good for him. He's got more endurance than me. Paul Sandu, is GPS proof of solid firmament above and flat Earth below? He's cranking them out. Russian vids, I think it's a reproduction, but it's 6 commercial airplane emergency landings that prove the Earth is flat. Not just the one where the child was born and they had to divert to Alaska, but there was 5 other flights that were very interesting. So check that out. See if there's anything else here. More Black Hole Interactive, Political Hillbilly, West Truther, Quasi-Luminous, yeah. All good stuff. So thank you, everyone that was making vids out there. Oh, yeah, and also check out the, because it was released at least a few days ago, but for whatever reason, it's not showing up in my search engine right away, is the Flat Earth Frozen Lake Test, 7.5-mile Frozen Lake Test. That is awesome. Phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. That is 720-897-6111. Let's knock out a few more emails. This one's from Phil. Mark, love your work. Keep provoking free and critical thinking among the masses. I can't wait to read your preparation ideas. If you would be so kind to send me a copy, kind regards, Phil. Yes, if anyone wants a free survival guide, and this might be a good year for it, you can email me at msargent, S-A-R-G-E-N-T, 23 at comcast.net. Just put survival guide in the title. I'll send it to you. It's only 2 megs. Should fit in your email box. I think it's 702 area code, 7 something. You're on live with Strange World.
Hey, it's Candy.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm North Carolina. I tried to call earlier, but I didn't get through. And when I call, like, I'm listening to you from my phone. So when I go and I get off the app and I get to my phone, I can't tell if you've answered another call or not.
I know there's a little bit of a delay, so I'm sorry about that. But eventually, I'll pick up pretty much everybody before it's over. So you're obviously going to this thing.
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm the one that commented on the video the other day because I had a feeling last week when I talked to you. I told everybody all week. I was like, I think they're gonna have a flat earth thing in North Carolina, and everybody looked at me like, yeah, okay, you're crazier than I thought.
Yeah.
I was like, no, because I can tell by the way he said it. And they were like, yep, you're in the loony bin next week, you know. But
yeah,
I was so happy.
It's so exciting. I'm thrilled. And actually, it's as you probably heard earlier on the show, it's a great location because it's central East Coast. There's a lot. There's a big population. You know, a lot of the people are out there east of the Mississippi. And even though West Coast, you could probably find some cool venues and cool locations. Look, if you want to hit the masses, that's where you want to go. Middle of the East Coast. So good for them.
But I'm kind of worried. I wanted to get a VIP ticket, and I'm not going to be able to buy my ticket until the end of the month.
Well, don't sweat it. There's a couple things that might happen there. One, you might they might expand the VIP stuff if it sells out, you know, within a week, and it looks like it's going to happen. They may extend that. So don't worry about that. Plus, honestly, everybody, this is between you and me, everybody that goes to this thing, there's going to be people are going to attend every single thing, from what I can tell. Like, I'm not going to miss a single session.
Yeah, me either.
So everyone's going to be in the room regardless. The VIP stuff, yeah, that puts you in the first couple rows.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean, I mean, everyone's going to be around. And plus, there's going to be when people are doing signings, like I'm pretty sure Rob Skiba is going to do a book signing. My publisher is going to come out. I'm going to do a book signing. Everyone's going to be around.
Yeah, I'm bringing my book.
Nice. Outstanding. People are going to be accessible. So don't worry about that. It's a cool thing, sure. But at the same time, you know, it's still so early. You never know. That, in fact, hang on. Peanut Gallery is mentioning to me, VIP has sold out officially, but that's not a big shock. Oh, no, no. It was going to. But again, it may be expanded. You don't know. If it sold out as quickly as it did, they may try to do something there. You never get so far out. It's so far down the road that don't worry. Don't fret.
I'm just glad that it's happening. I don't care if I have to stand in the back corner.
Oh, yeah. No. It's not going to be like that. There's people. You're going to be able to talk to all sorts of people. It's you know what, make sure, and I'll of course remind people a long time before that, but just make sure that we, like, when people, if you've listened to this show and you want to meet me, two things, you know, if you're gonna come up, because I get so many phone calls and so many emails, bring a snippet of your email with you, or bring, you know, if you got a license plate, bring me a freaking picture of your license plate so you can show me real quick, because that otherwise my mind is going to start twisting gears. It's like, okay, who are you again? Because I know, like,
yeah, you can't remember everything.
I can't remember everybody, and everybody's, you know, there's unique people, but don't worry, you and I will definitely get a chance to talk.
That's awesome. I'm so excited about it.
Cool.
But I was thinking, like, what if satellites are in the sky for GPS? I don't believe they are, but I don't know how they do it. And then I started thinking those vans or whatever they are that have the satellites on them that take pictures from Google. I'm pretty sure that's how they do it.
Well, here's the thing. Google Images and 510 area code, please give me a few minutes with her. Anything you see from Google Images can be taken from spy planes or even commercial airliners. You can hook it up to just about anything. And remember, all you have to do is stitch the images together and then zoom out and make sure that it fits around a sphere, and that's it. It kills me when people say, oh yeah, by the way, how does Google Earth work? Because it looks like it's being taken from thousands of miles away. I'm going, no. Those pictures are just stitched together. You could take those from literally 10 miles up and no one would know the difference.
You can take a picture on your phone and zoom it out and it looks like it's from 10 miles away.
Bingo. Absolutely. Absolutely. So, yeah, and when it comes to satellites, I still think that NASA has look up the NASA balloon system that has been running since the 50s. I think there's stuff flying around there. No question. Do I think that the majority of them are part of our civilization's space programs? No, I do not. And for anyone that doesn't know me already, get a pair of night vision binoculars. Don't break the bank doing it. Start looking up in the sky and tell me if you think those are all freaking balloons or satellites. They do not act like
that. Yeah, I was watching Crow 777. I've seen the moon pulse that he's had video, but I never actually saw his other videos with the objects flying around the moon. I was like, wow.
Oh, you want? If you're into that, have you looked up a channel called, and I don't know if I still subscribe to him, maybe I'll do it again, called UFO Lou?
I don't think so.
Look that one up.
I think I've heard of him.
Look up a channel called UFO Lou. He takes night vision cameras. He just sets them up, points them at a certain spot in the sky, and lets them run all night, and then edits them in the morning, you know, to see what he got. It's amazing what he gets. Amazing what he gets. And he's looking at not even a tenth of a percent of the sky at night. And that's what he sees. And that's, again, if you take out night vision binoculars, you won't even be able to, you'll lose count of how many things you will cross the sky in any given hour. It's amazing.
Yeah. So. I never even thought about it before. I thought the whole alien thing was crazy.
Well, it's not crazy. There's still stuff up there, but they're just not from Venus and Mars and Saturn.
Yeah.
They're just, in fact, you've heard me say it. They're just older versions of us. They were there before. I think that there were survivors of whatever continent was Atlantis. There were survivors of the sunken Japanese or the sunken Hindu. And the Mahabharata in India, it describes, you know, technical manuals and what they built. But I think whoever survives is not allowed to mingle with the groups that are down here. I think that we are still supposed to act naturally. For a whole other thing I don't want to get into right now because it takes a lot of time. Anyway, I want to see how many more calls I can squeeze in this evening. But thank you. And I'm so happy you're going to go. And don't, you know, again, we'll make sure, you know, if you keep calling, I'll make sure that at the very least we meet up at some point and we'll get a chance to talk, okay?
Awesome. Cool.
All right. Hey, have a good one. Talk to you soon.
Happy Valentine's Day.
All right. You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, let's see if we can pick up. I'm going to pick up 651 first before 510. You are on live with Strange World right now. Last segment. Who are you? Where are you calling from?
Hey, Mark. I'm Joshua. I'm from Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Right on.
Long time caller, first time listener.
Nice. What's on your mind this evening?
Hey, I was on this idea for about a month or so, trying to think of something that could, you know, help identify people who don't believe in the space program. You know,
okay.
You know, flat earthers, hollow earth, kind of, you know, whatever you want to, you know, label yourself as. But just as a whole, you know, we don't believe in the space program. I think that's something that we can all really agree on.
Right, exactly.
So I came up with this idea about wearing two rings on your finger. And I've been doing it for a month now. And I just went online on Amazon.com and ordered a black and white ring. Most of us who believe in, like, conspiracy theories and stuff like that understand duality and the black and white.
Right.
Concept.
Yeah.
So I put a black ring on my left finger in the middle, my middle finger.
Yeah.
And I put a white ring on my ring finger. And it identifies yourself as the black is all the lies that we've been taught growing up. And it's kind of on the middle finger for a reason.
Yep.
You can figure that out.
Yep.
And the white ring represents the truth that we're seeking, and that's on your ring finger.
Hey, that's pretty clever. I like that.
So I kind of spanned a couple of your videos with that idea, your most recent videos.
Okay.
And I also spanned Jernism and Eric Dubé, and just kind of trying to get the concept and the idea out there just so that we can kind of look at somebody's, because I look at people's fingers all the time just
sure.
to see if they're married. You know, like, it's just something I think humans do.
Sure.
And
that's not bad.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I put it on my Facebook page too, because I get a lot of slack, you know, from friends and family regarding my idea about, you know, the space program and stuff. And I've been approached actually by a few people who are intrigued about my rings, and it gives just an open conversation about, you know, because it's bringing them to you instead of being the one that's, you know, don't burden me with your religion type of deal.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure. Huh. All right. That's good. You know, no, because we've been looking for designators. Because like with anything, you don't know the person. You could be walking by flat earthers on the street. You never know it. And some people have said, well, you know, use like they use blue painter's tape when you're trying to let other people know you support law enforcement. And some people say, well, we should use green painter's tape. I'm going, that's not bad. But when it comes to the person, the individual, I'm thinking, okay, either enamel pins or, you know, but rings, not bad. I like it. I hadn't even heard that idea until now.
Thanks. Yeah, I really appreciate the time and the opportunity to talk to you.
Sure.
I would have to say that I did get my eyes opened probably a year ago this month by Eric Dubé's 200 Proofs.
Sure.
And unfortunately, he started going into, you know, a lot of New Age yoga ideas and concepts, and being a born again Christian and believer in Jesus Christ, I just can't completely agree with everything he says, but I don't throw the baby out with the bathwater.
Yep. Yep. I know.
So,
I know. I mean, there's the great thing about the community is there's someone there for just about everything. Everyone's on our side of the field carrying slightly different flags, but at least we're on the same side of the field, which is nice.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. I totally agree. I think that you touch on a lot of stuff that really is intriguing, and Jainism, he does a lot of stuff. You know, Russian, I mean, obviously you guys we're having a conference in North Carolina, so a lot of people are going to be able to see these people face to face, because it's very hard to trust people online, because you really don't know who's in it for the money, who just
right.
you know comes up with, like, oh, I'm a globe Earth person, so I'm going to create a video and get 200,000 hits just to, you know what I mean, just to kind of stir the pot. And
it
would be nice to find out who is genuine, because you're speaking to people face-to-face, you know?
Yeah, which is, again, why the conference is going to be so important, because then it's going to be a critical mass. It's going to be a big coalescing of a lot of people that are going to be in the same mindset, and it'll just everyone will reaffirm each other, which will be fantastic. Then you don't have to worry about labels necessarily, and I think it's going to be such a positive thing. I cannot wait for it. Anyway, I want to do one more call before I shut down tonight. Do you have any shout outs before I let you go?
Yeah, I just, the black and white ring thing, I think I don't expect it to catch on, but it's just something that I do. It's just something that I do on my own personal walk here on Earth. And, I just want to do a shout out to all the people who are kind of in the closet per se.
Okay.
Be open, you know, be who you are, but don't shy away from talking about it, because you never know who you're going to spark an interest and lead them down a bunny trail that it might help them.
Yeah.
When I first became a Christian, I became an evangelist. I just started sharing Jesus Christ with everybody, and it's my own personal walk. But I think that people need to be really open, because I think something's going to happen this year that is going to really affect this,
idea. Cool. Cool. Right on.
But really quick, I just wanted to share, I forgot, the reason why I came up with this idea is, it was probably Albert Einstein, right, who came up with this old Roman proverb.
Yeah.
Two Roman senators are talking and conversating, and one Roman senator says to the other, we have so many slaves, and they all dress the same. Like, everybody in the city all dresses the same, actually.
Right.
And they have slaves, and they wanted a way to identify their slaves and separate the common folk.
Uh-huh.
And the other senator says, well, that sounds like a great idea, but if we give everyone their own identity, they will see who is a part of their own slave community, and they will rise up against us.
Ah. Nice. Interesting. I like it.
Well, thanks a lot, Mark.
No worries, man.
Continue to press on, and God bless you and everything that you do, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you, and you have a good night, okay?
Thanks, man.
Okay, bye-bye. Okay, guys, last call. Whoever it is, I know there's two people at least fighting for it, 551 and 510. Whoever calls in first gets it, and it's going to be 551. I'm sorry, 510, you're going to have to – you know what? Who called most? 510 or 551? I'm going to take 510. Sorry, 551. All right, 510, you are the last call of the night.
Hey, Doctor. What's going on, Mark Sargent?
Hey, man, where are you calling from?
I'm calling out of Pittsburgh, California.
There's actually a place called Pittsburgh, California?
Yes, it is, over in the Bay Area.
Oh, right on. What is on your mind tonight? You got 4.5 minutes.
Yeah, I'm going to make it quick, man. First time live listening, first time calling on my first time calling in. So, boom.
Right on.
Yeah, Mark, we hooked up, we called in earlier. We hooked up on Xbox about 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's the one who told me about the show and how to, you know, be able to listen live and so on and so forth. This won't be my first time calling in. I will call in another time because I know we're short. But I'm just stoked that I was able to actually call in. My uncle is the one who actually got me into this rabbit hole sometime last year. And, we're going to try to see if we can make it out to North Carolina. We got a cruise coming up for our grandmother who's turning 80 in September. So I got a lot of time up. That's already on the calendar. I'm like, man, every time something comes up, I don't already put time into my job. I'm a commercial bus driver. I was over here scrambling trying to be able to get a call in before my shift had ended, so on and so forth. But I just wanted to let you know that I appreciate the work. Like I said, this won't be the last time that I'll try to call in. Rob Skiba, Zen Garcia, Glowbusters, I keep up with their work often. And every time you post up on YouTube, I list all the material. And also, what is it with Patricia Steer?
Yep.
I tune into that. And now I'll be listening in live every time I get the opportunity to. So, yeah, I appreciate the work that you do, sir. And, yeah, keep up the great work.
All right. Well, thank you.
And my name is Lathaniel, if I didn't say that.
All right, man. Hey, you have a good night, okay?
All right. You take care, Mark, and I look forward to catch you on the next one. Have a
all righty. Okay. Bye-bye.
All right. Take care. Bye-bye.
Okay, before I forget, guys, I know someone's going to try to call in anyway, but I am on Flat Earth and Other Hot Potatoes with Patricia Steer tomorrow. Yes, okay, I'll take 551. Tomorrow, Patricia Steer, Flat Earth and Other Hot Potatoes, check it out. I'm definitely going to be there. I'm going to take this last call. All right, 551, you were patient. What do you got?
Hey, how you doing, Mark? Listen, I mean, I'm not even in the area that Bradley J broadcast out of, but I listened when you were on, what was it, last week, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, in Boston, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I thought that couldn't have went any better than it actually did. I mean, besides him coming out and saying, you know, I'm a flat earther now, I mean, I thought that went fantastic.
Yeah, I thought it went as well as it could, believe it or not. I was not disappointed, really. I mean, he was a little rushed, but I knew he was going to because the phone lines were going to blow up, but I couldn't warn him that they were going to blow up. So,
yeah, but like people calling in, you know, with questions, and this happens a lot with this subject where people are asking questions that are ridiculous or they're not following the basic premise
yeah.
that you're drawing out. He corrected them almost every time, I mean, in my opinion, to the best of his ability. So, I heard you make at least I felt that you maybe didn't feel so great about the way that went.
Yeah.
I mean, certainly nothing like the way the SiriusXM interview went.
Oh,
I mean,
no, nothing like that. No, after
those guys
that,
were terrible.
Yeah, that was about as bad as, and he was so excited. He's going, the producer couldn't have been happier because apparently people don't call in that enthusiastic. So, whatever. So, but no, I've been on worse. So I'm not disappointed. And yeah, he was very polite and I wish we could have done a pre-show or a post-show, but that, again, it's not a big deal. I've done enough of them that I'm not worried. Any shout-outs before I close the show? Because we are done in 90 seconds.
No. Good. No, I know it's late. Go ahead. Thanks, Mark. Bye.
Hey, have a good night, okay?
Bye.
Bye-bye. All right, guys. Remember, I'm going to be on Flat Earth and Other Hot Potatoes tomorrow at, I think it's 3 o'clock Pacific, 6 o'clock Eastern. Thank you to everybody that called in tonight. It was pretty much wall-to-wall phone calls. Thank you for the emails. I'm going to try to do another Q&A email show. If you email me and I do not read it on the show, which is becoming less and less frequent, I will do a Q&A show and post that on YouTube. Thank you to the Peanut Gallery, who is always there for research and sending me funny comments when I'm not expecting it. And remember the conference, I'm going to keep hyping this thing. The UFO is going to, my spaceship is going to be parked, anchored over this conference in Raleigh, North Carolina for the duration, basically. I'm just going to keep promoting this thing as much as I can because it's great. I think it's a wonderful thing. Anyway, stay tuned for the next episode coming up next week. Same flat time, same flat channel.
Model of the flat geocentric earth. Nice.
I had to make a new one. What are you doing?